Hello, gardening friends. Welcome to Backyard Basics. I'm John Dromgoole. Well, we end up with problems in our garden sometimes as the weather changes, maybe from winter to spring, or goes in and out of winter and spring. The plants get distressed because they think it's one season or the other. And when they're distressed, here come the insects that do the damage. It's their job to get rid of the weaker species. So as we see that, we need to do something about managing those. So there's some homemade remedies. There's always something around the house that will manage some of the insects. Here's one of the traditional ones, and it's the blending of peppers. I'm not going to touch those because they're very hot. And then some garlic. You blend the two of those together, and there's different formulas. There's books out there that will show you how to make these blends. And so you blend the garlic and the pepper, and it's one of the best insecticides that you're going to find for homemade remedies. Another one is eggshells. Now, eggshells are very sharp, and so when slugs or snails coming over to the plants, you put it around the base of the plant. Last year we had a big snail problem. So we put those around the base in containers, or out in the garden you can put quite a few out there also. Around the seedlings, that is. And that will keep them off of there. And that's really important when they're getting started because they will nibble the edge of it and the plant will fall over. So that's a good way to keep them away. Another thing that we use is coffee grounds. They have a tendency to slow down those slugs and snails also. Some other insects, it keeps awake longer and they do a lot more damage. But it's a great mulch and a great nutrient also. So coffee grounds are another thing not to waste. Go ahead and use them in the garden. And it doesn't make any difference whether it's a plant in the ground or a container plant. They're all going to benefit from the coffee grounds. Now, some flying insects are managed easily too with these types of traps. These are called sticky traps. And they have a nice gluey substance on them. And all the insects are attracted to the yellow color. And so this is placed in the ground next to the insects in the garden or in container plants indoors. A lot of us have flying insects like gnats, fungus gnats. They get caught on this rather easily. These are replaceable. I think that this is a very good alternative, non-toxic, and it will do the job for you as to manage flying insects. Now there's one here that's white, and that is for the white fly. The white fly will go to that one every time, and you'll get management of those. Also, there are many products on the market that if you don't have time to make your own, you can select from some of these. And they're all safe to use, certified organic, and it's the kind of thing you want to use around your home. Now, the books, they're great, and there are many of them. Actually, there are some books that the city of Austin produces, too, about well-adapted plants. It's not so much that in and out of the season, but about plants that are well-adapted. And when they're well-adapted, they're much more resistant to insects. And one thing you need to remember that is that if you kill a beneficial insect, you inherit their job. Skip Richter always mentioned that one. For Backyard Basics, I'm John Dromgoole. I'll see you next time.